Lana Del Rey, who is she? What is she? Where is she? Can someone tell me? I want to find her in a nice way, obviously, and like a like not in a creepy way. Today we're listening to Million Dollar Man, obviously, by Lana Del Rey. This is track 10 of Born to Die. Let's go. Ooh, I like that.
You said I was the most exotic flower.
She sounds different again. I don't know how she manages to do this every single time. She sounds different. Sound a bit Britney Spears in that, and she said, "I love you, honey." So I'm guessing this is about she doesn't know how someone would get over someone as dangerous, tainted, and flawed as you. I'm gonna guess it's another toxic relationship Lana Del Rey is a part of, which seems to happen a lot, doesn't it, Lana? You know, if this pattern keeps repeating, maybe, just maybe, something needs to change. I mean, maybe it has, because this came out 10 years ago. Screwed up and brilliant, look like a million dollar man. So why is my heart broken? Is that her? She sounds completely different. Man, I just find some of these songs so like, she's so damn bad, but the thing she's saying is so like understandable, you know, just to like people who've been in relationships similar to this. She words it in a certain way, just gets it out, and I don't know about you, but when I'm listening, I'm just like, yeah, I've been there, you know. It's weird. It's really cool. She just taps into your head. Get out of my head. I really like that. I don't even know what it is. The echo. I like that it's sort of like, sort of distorted in a way. I really like it. Is that her? It's really distorting, like really. I like that a lot. It's just so, there's so much space in that. I think what's happened there is there's a bit of, it seems to be traveling across, but it's also very low frequencies that are passing through. So I think it's a little bit of bandpass filter which is in use there.
The prettiest people do the ugliest things. You know that.
Ooh, I like that final note. Okay, and the track's done. And then, oh, the track after this is Summertime Sadness. I've already reacted to this song. If you want to see me react to it, I might actually do the, you know, the end card thing at the end. I'm going to do that for once. I never do that. Maybe I should start doing that, you know. That's actually kind of sick. So that leads straight into Summertime Sadness. I want to hear a little bit of this song again because I love this song. Yeah, I love that song. So, I'm just thinking about the flow of the album. Oh. Ooh. Oh. So, the original Born to Die album is 12 tracks long. Million Dollar Man is track 10. And then we got Summertime Sadness. And then we got the closer, which is This Is What Makes Us Girls. So, that's the end of the actual album. But then we've got Deluxe. And then we got the Paradise Edition, and then we got the Paradise Edition special version. Wow, there's a lot of different versions going on here. Okay, it seems like Paradise was an album in its own, but it's only 8 tracks. So I think it's more of like a, I don't know what you really call it in this type of music. If this was rap, this would be a mixtape, or an EP. I guess Born to Die is such a like put together piece anyway that she just wanted to add the Paradise songs onto Born to Die, just so it's like a big complete product. 15 out of 8 songs, so that's, what's 15 out of 8? Oh my god. 15 out of 5, 20, 23, there's 23 tracks. Million Dollar Man reaction video. I put out a vlog yesterday. If you want to see my vlog, then go watch it. I had a lot of fun making it, and I want to know if you guys enjoyed it, because I might do some more. So yeah, go watch that. Go watch my Summertime Sadness reaction. And the next time, I'll be back with the last track-ish of Born to Die. Tell me which one you guys want me to do. Do you want me to carry on and finish the deluxe, or just finish the normal album? But anyway, that's it. Goodbye, guys. Have a good evening.